And they're here. Who's going to be talking to these guys? It's going to be me. And who's going to be phoning in questions? It's going to be you. NSYNC for the hour, next on Larry King Live. Only program in the world to give you President Carter one night and NSYNC the next. But they're here, all five of them, NSYNC, the hottest musical group in the world. Let's meet them individually. We're going to have a lot of fun tonight, include your phone calls. They're Justin Timberlake. He is the youngest member at age 20 and was a member of the Mickey Mouse Club. J.C. Chazay, 24 years old, from Bowie, Maryland, was also a member of the Mickey Mouse Club. My man, Joey Fatone, born in Brooklyn, one block from where I was born. He'll be 24 on January 28th, and he wants to be Superman. Chris Kirkpatrick is the oldest member of the group. At 29, Chris was born in Clarion, Pennsylvania, and the last member of the group is Lance Bass, who is only 21. Lance was born in Clinton, Mississippi, once wanted to be a space engineer, wanted to work for NASA, and look where he wound up. How did this... We'll start, I guess, with... You're the oldest, Chris. I'll start with you. How did this group come together?
Well, you know, it's a lot of hard work. We started about 6 years ago. We used to do a lot of a cappella singing together. We were friends. I worked with him at Universal Studios in Florida. And those two worked together, like you said, on the Mickey Mouse Club. And
Lance?
We don't know Lance.
I don't know where I fit
in. He just keeps following us everywhere.
You work together.
Lance is our best fan. So.
You work together like doing what?
We actually, I sang at a 50s doo-wop thing, and he was dressed up as a monster.
It's called the Beetlejuice Gary View Show.
So how, JC, did the five of you come together to be a group?
Well, it's a weird story, but basically how it runs is each person knew somebody else in the band, you know, whether they were working or just friends. Chris was the one who initially came up with the idea to start a group, and he approached Justin because they were friends and they had met in different places, you know, passing each other, whether it be in auditions for commercials or whatever in Florida. Justin and I, of course, were doing the Mickey Mouse Club, and after that ended, him and I started working on songs together. And then when Chris came up with the idea, he approached Justin. Justin called me up. The three of us were singing together.
Are you still with us?
I'm with you.
It goes.
Still haven't found out about Lance.
Lance is coming in. Don't worry. I'm going to get there. Now, after the three of us were together, Joey, believe it or not, was one of my first friends when I moved to Florida to do the Mickey Mouse Club. So him and I were friends, and Chris knew him from work, and so we both knew he could sing. And after the three of us got together, we were out one night and ran into him and said, you know what, we started a group. Why don't you join the group, man? And
He said yes.
He said, of course.
Sure. How much money you giving me?
Was it named NSYNC then?
No, not yet.
No, it was actually, what was it?
Not entirely done.
Well, how does Lance get in?
And then when the four of us came together, we were singing and we would try and gig and everything like that. And it just, the sound wasn't quite right yet.
We needed one more.
And we needed a bass.
We did not have a true bass voice in all four of us. And we initially wanted to do this group because we wanted to be one of those groups who sings a cappella. We wanted that to be our niche. And so my vocal coach, we got in contact with him. I took from him from when I was about 8 years old to about 11 years old, and we got in touch with him, and he gave us Lance's name, and he said, but his mother will never let him do it.
But
so
she did.
We had to convince Mom.
Thanks, Mom.
And then you became NSYNC. Did someone name you NSYNC, or you named us?
My mother came up with the name. Yeah, the first time we sang together, she goes, man, you guys sound really NSYNC. And we were like, ding, ding, ding.
Did you have a hit right away?
No, we were rehearsing for about a year.
We had a lot of hard work and a little house that three of us lived in, and actually Lance came down and lived in for a while.
In Orlando?
In Orlando.
That's where you live. You guys live in Orlando.
We practiced there. We did everything we possibly could. I mean, we worked so hard just trying to get anything, trying to get somebody to notice us and trying to get
it. What made it for you? Was there a break?
About a half a year after we were together, we hooked up with our manager, Johnny Wright, and he led us to a record company, and you know, that was the beginning.
And was that record a hit?
It wasn't a hit here. We spent a little over a year in Europe touring and busting our butts trying to get noticed over there. We signed to a German label because they were the only people that would pay any attention to us, really. And after spending a little over a year there, we came back to the United States kind of exhausted, and one guy from RCA, came to a show that we did in
Budapest.
A guy, Vince DiGiorgio from an A&R guy from RCA Records, came to a show in Budapest and saw us and said, "These guys have got something."
What was your first hit record?
I Want You Back in Germany. Yeah, first single was I Want You Back. It was weird.
I Want You Back in Germany.
It was weird because it was like, it was kind of rushed into it. It's like the minute we got there, we didn't even have a song or anything. Went up, we did a couple of photo shoots for some magazines, and we sang a cappella at some open air festival that they had.
We released that song, I Want You Back, before we even finished half the album of our first album.
It was like
20
days after we signed the record deal, so it was like a record.
What a thing it must have been.
It's cool.
I mean,
it was pretty wild. You know what was really strange is the fact that when we released, we started to get so big over in Europe so quick that we would get on the plane in Orlando and fly over to Europe and get off the plane, there'd be like thousands of girls just waiting, or just, you know, kids just waiting for us to get off the plane. We get off, it was all this, you know, we were celebrities. We get back on the plane and come home, and
nobody.
Our parents wouldn't even pick us up from the airport.
They have a sign holding up.
Yeah. Joey. Look for Joey.
Boy, that's got to be a weird feeling. Nice. We'll pick up on the career of NSYNC as we move ahead on this edition of Larry King Live. They won the American Music Award Internet Fans Artist of the Year Award last night. They're with us for the full hour. We'll include your phone calls. We're going to have a lot of fun. Learn a lot, too. Don't go away.